Okay, so this one's gonna be on ExpressVPN, and I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to be able to get it on Windows 10. Of course, this is a paid VPN, and it's a little bit more expensive than like IP Banish or a few other ones, but it just works a whole lot better, and it's like extremely simple to use. So the first thing you wanna go ahead and do is you wanna go ahead and type in ExpressVPN on your browser. Okay, and then here, just go ahead and click on get ExpressVPN. You do get a 30-day money back guarantee. Okay, so over here what you would do is you would go ahead and choose a plan. The most popular one is this one right here. However, since I already bought mine, it's a little bit more expensive. Yours should be like $6 and something, like $6.67 I think. Okay, and this is probably the best option. It does come out to $100, you know, but it's for like 15 months. So so basically, once you signed up for whatever you want, what you want to do is you want to go ahead and click on download. Okay, and that's going to give you the executable. Go ahead and save it, and then just go ahead and run it. It's very simple to install. And once you have it installed, this is what it looks like. And all you would do is you would just go ahead and basically enter the information as far as your credentials. Okay, and then to be able to set it up, it's very simple. What you would do, they have a list over here of different countries. You can also search in here by country or city, and just go ahead and click on that, and that's it. Okay, so over here you also can click on this hamburger menu, and you can click on VPN locations, and this will pop up. You can also go to the options over here. There's not too much to mess with, actually. You might want to launch ExpressVPN at Windows startup. And maybe you might want to click on if you wanted to connect to the last use location. You can also do what is called split tunneling, where you can manage connections per app. If you want different apps to use different different IPs. Okay, and then in here protocol automatic is recommended, so I just left it at that. And then, but you can also choose the one that you want to use. So if you want UDP with OpenVPN, which it shows you here, that is the best combination for speed and security, but it says it may not work on all networks. So if you want to enable that one, if you want TCP OpenVPN, you can also go with that. But really, I just left it at automatic. That way, choose just whatever you think is best, and then shortcuts. In here you can add or delete some of those, and then as far as browsers, you can install for the browsers. That's not really necessary, because once you have it on your actual operating system, then the browser's gonna get the settings by default. So under advanced, really there's nothing to mess with over here. Maybe you want to check the share crash reports. I think that one by default is enabled, but that's it. One thing, you can also add favorites. Let's say San Francisco is one of your favorites, so you can just click on the little star, and that's it. And I'm gonna go ahead and connect to it right now, and you're gonna see that it actually does it pretty quickly. So there we go. It's gonna take about maybe 5 seconds to be able to connect to the different server. Okay, one thing in here, sometimes it shows about the IP to see if there's any problems, and actually right now it looks like it's changed the message. But if you see that one, you can actually click on it, and what it does, go down here where it says tools, and then you can click on some of these. So what is my IP, DNS leak test, WebRTC leak test. So these are good, because actually I was not aware with the other one I was using, IP Banish. I did not get this, and this option at least, where it shows you whether there's a DNS leakage. And actually I had set it up with Cloudflare, and looks like that was not a good option. So I went ahead and disabled that, and just left it by default. So now it has no DNS leak. And if you see over here, it also shows WebRTC leak. So I just made a video on how to be able to disable the WebRTC from your browser. So Firefox, as you see, is showing that it's not, there's no leak, there's no WebRTC leak going on. So, and then the IP address checker, of course, you can check that, and it's gonna let you know where the actual IP is at. So that's how you're able to set up ExpressVPN with Windows 10. So that's it for now. Bye.